Hello everyone. Today, let's learn about particle ni. Particle ni has many different uses in Japanese grammar. Today, we will learn two main ways in which particle ni can be used. The first is where ni marks the indirect object in a sentence. We've already learned about what is direct object, and we've already learned that wo is the direct object marker in Japanese. Today, we will learn about indirect object. Indirect object identifies to whom or for whom an action is performed. In this case, it works very similar to to or for in English. Usually, an indirect object will work in a sentence only if there is already a direct object. Let's look at some examples. I write a letter to mom. Here, the action of writing is performed for mom. So, mom is the indirect object. And letter is the direct object as it is directly receiving the writing action. Similarly, I give a flower to my sister. What do you give? Flower. So flower is a direct object. And to whom do you give it? You give it to your sister. So sister will be the indirect object. I teach Japanese to students. Here, Japanese is a direct object and student will be the indirect object. Now, let's see how the sentence will work in Japanese, Hindi and Tamil. In Japanese, you would say, haha ni tegami wo kakimasu. Haha here is mother, ni is the indirect object marker and kakimasu is to write. Tegami wo kakimasu by itself means write a letter. To whom are you writing the letter? To mother or haha. So, you say, haha ni tegami wo kakimasu and you end the sentence with the verb. In Hindi, you would say ma ko chitti likhu and in Tamil, you would say ammakku letter eduven. Now, let's look at the second example that we did. I gave a flower to my sister. In Japanese, this would sound like this. Imoto ni hana wo agemasu. Hana wo agemasu means give flower. To whom are you giving this flower? To your sister. So, imoto ni hana wo agemasu. Imoto is younger sister, hana is flower and agemasu is to give. In Hindi, you'd probably say behen ko phool dun. In Tamil, you'd probably say tangaikku poo kudupen. Let's now move on to the second usage of particle ni that we'll be doing today. Ni, when used along with a specific time-related word such as January or say 9 o'clock can work like at or on in English. However, you should not use it with general time related words such as next month or today or last year and so on. Let's look at an example. Rokuji ni okimasu. Rokuji is 6 o'clock, ni is at and okimasu is wake up. So, you again finish the sentence with the verb and you put the ni after the time related word and you say rokuji ni okimasu. Let's now see how this sentence will translate to English, Hindi and Tamil. In English, you'd probably say I wake up at 6 o'clock. In Hindi, you would say 6 baje uthu. In Tamil, you'd say 6 manikku elundhupen. Now, if you notice in the previous usage too, you put a ku and said tangaikku poo kudupen, ammakku letter eduven. And now again, you put the same ku and you say 6 manikku elundhupen. Let's try a small quiz now. I teach Japanese to students. Let's try to translate this in Japanese. I is watashi, teach is oshiemasu. Japanese is Nihongo and students is Gakusei. You have to put the right particles in the right places and you have to finish the sentence with the verb, which is oshiemasu here. Similarly, you have another sentence, I go in May. Go is ikimasu, May is gogatsu. Can you tell me how this would sound in Japanese? If you know the answer, post it in the comment section below.